Hi friends, welcome. Today's BC, A Boy Looks at Cricket, written by Nevelly Cordes. About the author, Nevelly Cordes in 1889 to 1975 is perhaps the most famous and facilitious of cricket writers. He was equally an authority on cricket and music and a reporter of both for the Manchester Guardian. Born foreign parents in the slum of Manchester, he had only 4 years of school education. He was a self-educated man. He served as an assistant cricket coach at a school for a few years. This was the beginning of his career on the field, and later he was a writer. He has to his credit a number of books, notably a cricketer's book, The Days in the Camp and Cricket. He is known for his racy and straightforward style, for his excellent sense of humor. Outline of this lesson. Introduction. Hero worship in Nevelly Cordes. Contradiction in Nevelly Cordes. His reaction when Lanarkshire and Yorkshire clashed. Ranjit Singhji and Fry. And conclusion. Gist of the lesson. Nevelly Cordes considered McLaren, Spooner and Tyddesley of the Lanarkshire team of his heroes, but he regarded the members of the Yorkshire team as barbarians. He always prayed to God for divine help for his heroes, but when the Yorkshire bowler George East bowled, Cordes closed his eyes and wished George he could drop down dead before bowling. Nevelly Cordes loved the Australian player Victor Trumper as much as he loved the English players. He wanted Victor Trumper always to score a century, but also wanted England to win the match. Once in 1904, Lanarkshire was on the point of being defeated by Yorkshire. He went to Manchester and came to know of the details of the match from the different editions of newspapers. He performed various acts to get the gods to his side and Lanarkshire sides. Lanarkshire's day was saved by a century by Tyddesley. Ranjit and Fry in all their splendour were chosen to meet Australia at Lord's. Both were bowled out for 0 run by the Australians. Cordes was shocked. The downfall of the English team was brought out by an uncrowned Australian bowler by name Hopkins. Summary. A Boy Looks at a Cricket, Nevelly Cordes. Introduction. A Boy Looks at Cricket is an extract from Nevelly Cordes' autobiography. In it, he reveals his admiration for his heroes in cricket and his mastery most of facilitious style. Hero worship in Nevelly Cordes. Nevelly Cordes hero worshipped the Lanarkshire team, but he hated the Yorkshire team. He thought that his favorite cricketers were the best in the world. He considered McLaren, Spooner and Tyddesley of the Lanarkshire team as his heroes, but regarded the members of the Yorkshire team as barbarians. He always prayed to God for the heavenly aid for his heroes. But when the Yorkshire spin bowler George East bowled, Nevelly closed his eyes and prayed that God wrist would drop down dead before the bowling next ball. His prayers were not on his own behalf, but on behalf of his darlings of cricket. Contradiction in Nevelly Cordes. Sometimes Nevelly Cordes got himself into difficult position with God. Victor Trumper, next to McLaren and Spooner, was most ordered. He was an Australian and Nevelly was a patriotic English lad. Nevelly was self-contradictory in his prayer to God. He wanted Victor Trumper always to score a century, but he also wanted England to win the match. Reaction when Lanarkshire and Yorkshire clashed. Once in 1904, Lanarkshire was near defeat at Leeds against Yorkshire men. Nevelly was on pins and needles. He could not go to Leeds. He went to the nearest city. Manchester and came to know of the latest details of the match from the different edition of the newspaper. He performed various acts to get the gods in his sight and on the landscape side. He stood over a grid in a gutter and told himself that if he could spit throughout it without touching the bars, landscape would be spared. McLaren and Spooner had gone early. Tidalcy was still not out. Landscape's day was saved by a century by Tidalcy. The day thus revealed its best and worst. Ranjit Singh Ji and Fry in the test against Australia. Years passed, new players appeared in the cricket scenario. Ranjit Singh Ji appeared as an Eastern king wearing a ruby studded crown and being taken out in procession and elephant. C.B. Fry appeared as Ranjit Singh, Grand Vizier and Prime Minister. Ranjit was a tremendous batsman. He scored 3,000 runs in a season averaging nearly 90. Fry scored 6 centuries in a successive innings. The crescendo of Fry's 600 sent all school boys into fevers of amazement and admiration. Conclusion. Ranjit and Fry in all their splendor were chosen for England to meet Australia at large. Both Ranjit and Fry were bowled out for 0 run by Australian. Neville was deeply shocked. Jackson helped McLaren to stop his striking discipline and fall. England was 102 for 2 wickets. The pride of the English team was humbled by an uncrowned Australian bowler by name Hopkins. The defeat of English team was bowled by heavy rage. Neville Cordes thus looked upon his heroes at cricket with emotions terribly mixed. A model paragraph. Explain the statements. Sometimes I got myself into difficult position with God. There was a Victor Trumper. He was an Australian. Next to McLaren and Spooner, he was a Cordes most ordered. Cordes was a patriotic English lad. He wanted to Victor Trumper always to score a century. But he also wanted England to win the match. The problem was how to pray simultaneously for the victory Victor Trumper as well as his one English team. He resolved with a dilemma by praying to God to let Victor Trumper score a century out of a total 137 ball all outs. Thank you for watching this video. All up blessings.